that you spend invested in the Lord. So you spend invested in His Word, spend invested in fellowship, spend in praying or beseeching God, and applying, and not only hearing it, of course, but applying God's Word to your life will determine how deeply you get into the Word and how deeply the Word gets into you. That's the difference between a weak cup of tea and a strong cup of tea. Now remember, in conclusion, this principle. Just like the tea, the longer you are in the Word, the stronger you will become. Just like the longer you're in the world, the stronger in the world you're going to be. But the stronger, However, the weaker will be that great divorce between your knowledge and your practice. As you get stronger in the Word, that gulf between knowledge and practice begins to close up. And that divorce, what you begin to do is you begin to heal that relationship between knowledge and practice. It becomes closer and closer and closer. You're mending that relationship. There's no longer that separation, but there's a drawing back together as you allow yourself more and more to be immersed in God's Word. He spelled it out for us pretty simply. He spelled it out to us pretty darn simple. Look, and you've got to choose it. You've got to choose whether you're going to audit this or whether you're going to take it for credit. Right? You've got to make up your mind whether you want the blessing. And if you want the blessing, then you've got to do the work. And the work is doing your homework. The work is confessing. The work is repenting. The work is listening to God. The work is immersing yourself in the Word so you become a stronger team. The work is getting up and fellowshipping. The work is serving and being a blessing to the destitute, those who cannot possibly be any benefit to you in the long haul, at least from the worldly standard. The work. You do that, then you start to heal that divide. But first, that has to happen. And if you want that to happen, then you got to make up your mind right now whether you're going to prepare your heart for that. You got to get ready for it. You got to prepare your heart, and then you got to be receptive to what God's going to do with that heart prepared. And then after you've got it, to apply it. To apply it. What God has blessed you with, to be obedient. And I'm using a play on words here, but this Shabbat, God wants to attack your heart. He wants to attack your heart. He wants to attack your heart because He wants you to know what it is to have faith that really has power and works.
Amen.
Amen. Please rise. I hope you appreciated the sermon. But I hope, most importantly, you got the message. Let's pray. Father, in Yeshua's name, we again thank you for your words. I thank you, Father, for a word that often disturbs us. Thank you, Herod, for sharing that we learned from your witness. That you still listened, even though it disturbed you. That troubled you. That made you uncomfortable. That convicted you. And I know, Father, often words come from various places, not just the pulpit, but various arenas of our life. Father, we hear things that trouble us or convict us. But Father, I pray that we keep on listening, that we keep our hearts open, receptive. And part of being here today is preparing our hearts to do that, to ready ourselves, because you speak, Father, in numerous ways, sometimes even through an ass. I've had many of them speak into my life. So, Father, I pray in Yeshua's name, Lord, that not only did we listen to those words, but then we will apply them. That we will apply them. Father, that we will be the difference makers. That we are not here, Father, just to gather information. But, Father, to be equipped, Father, for the work of the kingdom. Here and days to come. So I thank you, Father, for your words that have gone forth. May we treasure them and steward them and multiply them. May they be the talents, Father, of our soul. We pray these things in Yeshua's name, and the congregation says,
Amen.
Yivarech Yahweh Yivayish Barecha So Adonai Panavalecha Vichanecha So Adonai Panavalecha V'sim Lecha Make his face to shine upon you, be gracious unto you. And I pray the Lord will lift his countenance upon you and grant you his peace, his shalom. B'shem Yeshua Adonai, and the congregation says, Danny,
Amen. Amen.